friends. Welcome back to 50 Plus Beauty, where we 50 Plus women use great skincare, makeup, attitude, and health to stay in the game and make our second half just great. Today, we're going to discuss lip lines and wrinkles and the way to at least minimize them and really help our lips look better overall, I would have to say. And I wanted to let you know that the details of the outfit I'm wearing and this jewelry, which is just great, and it's from Amazon and it's really inexpensive, all of those details are below the video. And if you're not yet a subscriber, I would love to have you join us by clicking that bell and or giving this video a thumbs up. I would really appreciate that. Okay, here we go. Let's get into this video about kind of helping our lip lines and wrinkles, because recently quite a few of my viewers have been asking me how I deal with lip lines and wrinkles and that kind of thing. And I don't have them too badly, but back in October, I went to the dentist, and normally my dentist and hygienist, they know that I have a YouTube channel, and they normally comment on how nice and white my teeth are. But this time, the hygienist just said, "Oh, Beth, your lips are so chapped. They're so chapped." And then when I got out into the car, I looked in the rearview mirror, and it was like I had fur hanging off my lips. And I thought, "Beth, you've never even thought about your lips, because I'm pretty much of an oily skin girl. It has not been a problem until like this year." But I realized how awful that was, how chapped they were. And so I started buying a lot of different lip products. I bought a ton of different chapsticks. I spent over $30 on chapsticks. This is just the remnants. And very soon I realized I did not want to become addicted to these things. So I decided instead to do a nightly lip treatment. And I started with this one, which is the O'Keefe's Lip Repair. It's just a very nice little emollient lip product that you put on your lips when you go to sleep at night. And I like that, but I did more research and I found the big kahuna here. This is an Allure Beauty Award winner, and it's called the Laneige Lip Sleeping Mask. And here it is. They have it in like four flavors. This is berry, and it is just absolutely lovely. And it is just a little emollient, kind of a lip gel, and you just put it on your lips, and oh, it just feels so good. I'll go ahead and do it right now. I love this stuff, and it has kept me from having to use chapstick during the day, because it really does a beautiful job of healing your lips and making them very soft and pliable, and they really don't look like they have as many lines at all. It's absolutely wonderful. And on Amazon, people love it there. They had like 3,600, almost all five-star reviews, and there is a picture of that there. Here is one of the reviews. "Okay, this stuff is amazing. I was skeptical but wanted to try it. My lips get really dry and chapped, and I have a tendency to pick at them and make them worse. I've tried a million different lip balms. This stuff wins hands down. Plus, it's a big container and it won't be running out anytime soon." And I really do love the size of this container. It is about $20, so it's a little bit pricey, but I think it's going to last me a good long time. Now, another thing I've been doing is that every morning before I apply my makeup, I apply this City Lips Lip Plumping Clear Gloss. And here it is. It's just a little clear gloss. And I don't know that it plumps my lips that much, but I just put it on and then I get the rest of my makeup on. And I might end up using another lipstick and maybe even a different lip gloss. But in the 10 or 15 minutes that I'm applying my makeup, I really feel like my lips just get softer and more pliable, and they do plump up just a little bit. And I really do think that this is helping smooth out those lip lines. So I go ahead and apply this, and then I put my makeup on and I totally wipe that off, because then I apply this City Beauty Line Blurring Wrinkle Filter. And this is actually a wrinkle filler that you can use all over your face, but you can also use it on your lips to fill in those lip lines. And I have not tried it anywhere else on my face, but basically what you do, it has this little kind of funny little applicator there. You just kind of pump that and get a little bit of it on your totally dry lips, and then you apply it. I'll move in. Then you apply it. Just apply it. And then you just let it dry out. And while it's drying, I'll go ahead and read you a little bit about this product. "What does Line Blurring Wrinkle Filler do? Fill out the look of deep wrinkles, erase the appearance of fine lines, address wrinkle depth and amount, support firmness, tightness, and elasticity." And it receives excellent reviews, and here's just one of them. "I love this product. It really works. I actually only did half my face, and the difference was incredible. It even worked on the lip lines. Thank you so much." And let me tell you a little bit about the ingredients in this particular product, because the ingredient list is really twofold. The first key ingredient is a peptide and ceramide blend. It says a powerful peptide blend that supports skin's natural repair mechanisms for younger, smoother skin. And peptides help regrow the protein in our skin, and ceramides do the same thing. They pump up the collagen in our skin. So over time, that should have a smoothing effect on your lips, but it also gives you an immediate effect in smoothing down those lip lines. It has something they call diamond powder. It says, made of light reflecting particles, this luxurious ingredient instantly diminishes the look of fine lines and wrinkles by giving the skin a diffused soft focus effect. Okay, I don't know if you can see any soft focus effect, but there I am now. But as you can see, it just has given me a nice even canvas anyway to put on my lip products. And I think it really has kind of smoothed out those wrinkles. I guess you will have to be the judge of that, but please leave a comment below the video if you have an opinion. So now it's gotten dry. Actually, it's a little bit tacky to the touch, but that's just fine. And next, I'll move in here. I'm going to go in with a lip pencil, and I love this one. I've been using it a lot lately. This is the BK Beauty Everlasting Lip Liner in Sweet Pea, which is a great match for my lips. And they always say lip liner should be roughly the color of your own lips. So here we go. And always use lip liner if you want your lips to look a little plumped up. And I will give you one tip. And basically that is that the straighter you make this line between your two lip points, the fuller your upper lip is going to look. I can't do totally a straight line because it just looks kind of silly on me, but I will kind of exaggerate that just a little bit. It goes way down and I'll just smooth it out just a little bit. I can't go straight across. Okay, there you go, and that will give your lipstick a nice, evenly defined edge. And also, if you want to go just the slightest bit outside of your lip line, you can kind of pump up the look of your lips a little bit. Now, let's go in with the lipstick, and I've been using this Sephora number 3, and I love this. I wish they'd give it a name. It probably has a name. I can just see number 3. There we go. I think that's really pretty. And it goes without saying that as we get older, we should really pull back on using matte lipsticks, or if we use a matte, always follow it up with a nice lip gloss. And I have one of those. Actually, I have 5 of those. I went a little bit wild. This is the Maybelline Lip Lifter Lip Gloss, and it is fairly new, or at least it's new to me. And it is almost custom designed for us older people because studies have shown that it actually gives our lips a much more hydrated look, which we always need at this age. Here is a look at what they found. They said lifter gloss, 90% agree that lips feel more hydrated based on a consumer test. And there you can see the before and the after. And that has certainly been my experience with it. I've only had it for a few days, but I'm really loving it. And I'll show you this color in just a minute. This color is surprising because look how brown it looks. And this is a color called Crystal. As you can see there, the gloss itself looks brown and kind of murky. But on all the 3 various skin tones, in terms of light skin to very dark skin, it just gives it a beautiful kind of diamond-kissed look. And I really like that. And that's the experience I have with it. And let me show you all the shades it comes in. It comes in 15 normal shades. By normal, I mean not highly glossy. And then it has the new bronzed shades. And there they are at the bottom, really, really pretty. I don't have any of the bronze shades. I just have the normal shades. However, this crystal one is really fascinating. So I'll come in a little bit closer and I'll go ahead and put this on. It has a very large doe foot applicator, actually a very beautiful high-end looking case too, which I really appreciate. And on Amazon there, it's like $6.99, it's crazy. But look at that, it is absolutely beautiful. And there it is, and I absolutely love it. It didn't really change the color of that lipstick, amazingly enough, because it does look brown. It just makes it look a little more natural, and it's got that diamondy look to it that really transfers beautifully to the lips. And it just feels very moist and very hydrated. And if you've got winter dry chapped lips right now, at the very least, I would recommend an overnight sleeping mask to give you more hydration, more moisture. And then any lipstick that you use, always accompany it with a very moisturizing gloss. Okay, that was a quick look at what I'm using to really minimize my fine lines and wrinkles on my lips. And I found personally that as I get older, I can't really ignore my lips anymore. They need a little help to have the moisture that they've lost now that I've gotten to be a little more mature, shall we say. And again, if you're not a subscriber and you'd like to stay visible and in the game, then I hope you'll subscribe to my channel, click that bell for email notifications, and give this video a thumbs up if you would. Okay, I always like to leave you with a little thought for the day, a little attitude adjustment, and I've been reading from these Life Loves You cards from Louise Hay. Okay, let me go ahead and choose a card, hopefully something positive to think about for today. Ooh, this is interesting. Love speaks to me all through the day. Love speaks to me all through the day. And this is what it says on the other side. When you don't know what to do, focus on love. Love is an infinite intelligence that will always help you if you let it. When you don't know what to do, focus on love. Love is an infinite intelligence that will always help you if you let it. And friends, I absolutely do love this card. And the reason I love it is, to me, God is love. And when I'm focusing on love and I'm acting out of love, then I'm really doing God's will in my life, because that is what He wants for me. He wants me to use the many blessings that I have been given, the many lessons that I have learned. He wants me to share that with others in love. And when I do that, I am really doing His will. And I have to say, there are times in my day when I don't have that great attitude, and maybe I'll get a little angrier about something, a little bit bent out of shape. So friends, during those times when we get bent out of shape during the day, something happens that we didn't foresee, something like that, let's remember to hold ourselves back, rein ourselves in, take a deep breath, and focus on love. Because when we focus on love and follow where it leads us, it usually leads us to a much better, happier path. Take care, and I'll see you in my next video.